Motion graphics and animation are a great way of attracting attention and getting engagement on short-form social media videos. But finding and customizing the right motion graphics or video templates, like in Canva, can be time-consuming and a little tricky. So today, I'm going to walk you through step-by-step how to create your own motion graphics template in Canva, something that you can reuse quickly and easily, customize it for your brand, and make sure that it's easy for you to export super cool videos for Instagram Reels, TikToks, or even YouTube Shorts. To create this motion graphics template, we're going to follow the process that I always follow when I'm creating these kind of animations. It's something I teach inside my Canva course, and it's basically just a step-by-step to make sure I don't miss out any steps. Now, the first step is to make sure that we know what our sizes are and our safe zones. And so obviously we're going to be creating for social media video, so we're going to use the vertical format. But I want to gather my elements, which is the next step. And so I'm going to create a working document so that I can just gather everything in there, put it together, and then I can copy and paste it into the vertical video document, because this way I've got a bit more space to work with at the beginning. So this is my working document. And the first thing that I did was I brought in a phone frame just from Canva's graphics elements library. And this is just so that I can play around and create a background and see how it will look in this frame before I actually start working in that video. I also created this picture frame and I border around it. And this is what I'm going to use as a placeholder for the images that we're going to put in here. Now, one of the tricky things with sharing animation templates in Canva is that Canva's match and move tool, which I've talked about a lot, relies on you using the exact same element from one slide or one frame to the next. And that means if you change an image, it's no longer the same element. So that can cause some confusion in trying to create something that people can easily customize. So the way I got around that is by creating placeholders that I've numbered. So I know exactly which image or which number of placeholder is where and on which slide. Let me show you what I mean. This frame that I created, I also created a number of images just using a square format in Canva and exporting them as PNGs. And I've created four of them. And all I'm going to do is click those numbered images and put them into the frame so I can see which placeholder is where as we go forward. So on the next slide, you'll see I've created four of them. I've put the images, which are numbered 1 to 4, in there. And I've also got a shadow behind them. So our next step with creating these elements is to create the complex elements. And that just means I'm going to put this shadow behind the box with the image in to create a little depth. So if I click and drag this and it's going to go behind the image, you'll see Canva's trying to put it into that image placeholder. All you have to do is hit your command or control key while you're dragging that and it won't try and put it into the box. It will put it above or under it. So I'm going to just let go. Now you can see the shadows under there and there's a little bit of depth. So I'm going to select both of those elements and I'm going to hit control or command G or click this button here to group them. Now I've done that with all four of these here. So these are complex elements made up of an image box and a shadow, which are grouped. And I'm going to use them in this format of a grid of four on the actual design. Now I want to create a background for this video. And so I have just used this little arch image, which is again, just an element from Canva's library. If I make it a different color, you can see what it looks like. I found it in Canva's elements library and I'm changing it to white. And then I've created just a solid box underneath it, also in white. And these two are going to be grouped so that they form the background. And the reason I've done this is because I want something to shine through behind this background at the top here, because that's going to allow us to customize that as we go forward. Now for this particular motion graphic, I want to have a kind of gradient of color in the background there. And so on the next slide, you'll see I've just found something that I searched for gradient shape in Canva's image library, and I found this really beautiful gradient of color. Now what I've done is, when you click on it, you'll see I've actually applied a rotate animation to it. And all that means is that it will very subtly rotate in the background as this video goes on. It is very subtle, but it does create a little bit of movement and dynamism, and I like to do that when I've got these kind of gradient shapes. So if I just grab the playhead at the bottom here in the timeline, and I click and drag it, you'll be able to see how this rotates and moves. So it just creates a really nice effect, even if it is very subtle. The next thing I wanted to do was the final elements I'm going to use, which are some text elements. So the first one, I know that I want to have a big heading. I also want something where I can have a call out, like for example, for the website. And then I want something as a bit of a featured piece of text. So now that I have these elements, we're ready to put them together in our social video. And so I'm going to switch to a Canva design that is sized for social media or vertical video. So this is the video document that is going to ultimately be my final template. I put a blank slide in here so that you can see as I bring in or copy and paste the elements from my working document. First of all is that background group that I'm going to use. So I copied and pasted that, and that's of course made up of this top arch element and the bottom box, which are grouped. And you can see the background shows through from behind this element. Next, I copy and paste that subtly animated gradient because that's going to be in my background. So if I go to the position tool, you can see it's actually behind the white background so that you've got this nice soft white fade above it. Next, I'm going to copy and paste the heading in, and I want to make sure that that is over the colored area, but it's also quite subtle so the color shines through. And I've just done that by changing the transparency a little lower than 100%. And next, I bring in the four elements that are going to have images in. But for now, we're just using the numbered 1 to 4 placeholders ready for our final images and ready for us to create a template that we can customize. As you'll see in the timeline, I've put in a black slide here, and that's just to show me where our working slides stop and our proper slides for the video begin. First of all, I've put in a very short white slide, which is just 0.1 seconds, and that's just so that there is a quick fade from white into the gradient, which I thought would be nice to introduce it. On the first slide, I've put in that title, and I've added a breathe animation, which means it just very subtly increases or decreases in size. And I've put in these four images, which are animated by adjusting the timing on each of them. So if I click on the group and go to the three dots and then show timing, you'll see that I have adjusted the timing on each of them so that number one comes in first, then two, then three, then four. And you just do that by clicking and dragging on the handles of each of them as you want the timing to come in. So if I now use this playhead and scrub from the white slide, you'll see it goes from the white slide, it fades into the gradient and the headline, and then those four images come in, each one staggered. The next slide, I want to make more of a feature of each of these individual images. So that way you can profile maybe products, or you could put each of your packages on one of these, or maybe even speakers at an event or houses that you have for sale. It creates a lot of flexibility, which is what you want in a template. On this slide, I've made one of them big, and I've made the other three small along the bottom, almost like a slideshow with little thumbnails. Because I'm using the exact same elements, numbered 1 to 4, you'll see that when I click and drag here, I've applied the match and move animation between these two slides. And if I click and drag, you'll see number one becomes large and the other four animate to reduce size and move to the bottom because we're using the exact same elements. Then you'll see I've brought in one of those texts at the top that have the little script font, and I've just done that using a simple wipe animation. And once again, I've made sure that I check the timing so that it only comes in once the images have found their place. So that's how we're going to feature each of these elements one at a time. And so I just duplicate this slide and change the images around so that number 2 is featured, then number 3, and then number 4. One important thing to note is it makes it so much easier to resize things so they look consistent if you use the rulers and click and drag guides down to show you what size these need to be. So that way you can see the large one needs to fit within those two lines, and you can do the same for the smaller ones at the bottom. Of course, the other thing you can do is to literally use the sizings of each of these. So if you click on one of them and you go to the Arrange tab here, you'll see that the width and height is actually there in pixels. So you could adjust that if you wanted to be specific with that. So if we go back to that slide with the four of them in the same size, and I now click and drag this, having applied a match and move transition between each of those slides, you'll see number one features, then number two features, number three, and number four. Now lastly, I then took all four of them and staggered them just to make an interesting arrangement with a call out of a text box with a white background. I also moved that headline up, and you can see because of the match and move, it moves it really nice and smoothly and it looks really cool. And then I added a final slide with the images on where I just changed their position slightly, again, just to attract interest when people are watching it. And I've put the call out box at the bottom with a URL and a final call to action. So as I said, this can be used to promote pretty much anything. And the idea is that if you create it using placeholders like these 1, 2, 3, 4 images, you can then save this as a brand template and reuse it anytime you want and just change the content within it. But once you've branded it and made it look right for you using your right fonts, etc., it's a template you can reuse over and over quickly and easily so that you don't have to spend forever creating social media posts and videos. So let's have a play through this video and see what it looks like with our placeholders in, animations applied, and the match and move transition between the slides. And of course, I slapped a bit of branding on the end because that's kind of what I do. I'm actually going to be sharing this brand template with you in my next video next week. I will have a download where you can download this for free for you to use and customize as you will. And in next week's video, I'm actually going to show you how to customize this in 3 completely different brand styles, just using Canva's image and video library and clicking and dragging. And then I'll show you a few tricks and refinements to make it work for your brand. So if that's something that you're interested in and you'd like to get the free template next week, please go to the link on the screen right now or in the description below the video and sign up for my email list, because I will be sharing this next week through my email newsletter. And of course, I'll be sharing it on the video, which will be out next week, Thursday. So if you'd like to use this for yourself rather than creating it from scratch, you can do that if you pop back next week. Once you've created your template, if you are ready to save it so that you can reuse it anytime you want, it's as simple as going to the share button in the top right of Canva and then clicking on template link. And you can then copy that link, share it with anyone that you want, or paste it anywhere else. The other thing you can do, of course, is you could click share and you could choose to make it a brand template. And that means that it will be saved in your brand kit in Canva. So whenever you want to use it, you just need to go to your brand, and at the top you'll see there's a brand templates folder. If you click on see all, it will appear in there. So in next week's video, we are going to use this exact brand template and we're going to customize it just using Canva graphics, elements, and videos so that it works for 3 completely different brands that have a different look and feel and a different sector, so that you can see how easy it is for you to customize it for your own brand. And of course, as I promised, I'll be sharing this brand template link for you so that you can use this free of charge and make your own creations with it. That's it for today, folks. Have a fabulous week, and I will see you next week.